Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Welcome, dear brother, dear sisters, alhamdulillah, our community here in Los Angeles and California, and also especially in the valley, our brothers at the Islamic Center of Reseda. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi Alameen, salhu wa yubaligna Ramadan wa radir anna, and Ya Allah, help us, inshallah, to worship you in the month of Ramadan, to make deeds, inshallah, of khair, to worship you in a good manners, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Just let me fix this because I think it is not really proper, but it's okay. It's okay, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي عُدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. احنا always we said before the month of Ramadan, welcome everybody. We have to make a takhliyah qabla at-tahliyah. We have to cleanse in the house before we receive the guest. Ramadan is coming, inshallah, just 3 days. We're going to have Ramadan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Alaykum as-salam wa barakatuh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ. تَقُوا النَّارِ, fear the hellfire. Means protect yourself from the hellfire. Make good deeds. Make wiqaya, like a wall, a barrier between you and the hellfire. وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِكَفْرِينَ. The hellfire being prepared. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared the hellfire for the kafirin, for those who are denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who are away completely from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةِ. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran, verse 131. Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةِ عُدَّةِ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Fear, protect yourself from the hellfire, which is its fuel, people, الناس, and الحجار, stones, and being prepared for the kafirin. Allah prepared the hellfire for the kafirin. طيب. Now, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that? He said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ, fear the hellfire. Fear the hellfire, سَلْبِ مَضَرَّ وَجَلْبِ مَنْفَعَ. يعني سَلْبِ مَضَرَّ. If somebody will go to the hellfire, it's a big harm for him. It is not something good. Welcome everybody. حياكم الله. Welcome everybody. And also, جلب منفعة. جلب منفعة was to go to Jannah. Something will benefit you to go to Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hellfire, it's a madarra, it's harming. That's why in Islam, even in our worldly life here, the harm must be removed. It means الضرر يزال. There is no harm in Islam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His love to His ibad, to His mu'mineen, He said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ. Be careful, there is a hellfire. There is a nar, there is a hellfire, there is a punishment. Please try to make some good deeds. That the good deeds, it will be like a barrier, like a veil between you and the hellfire. Wiqaya, protection from the hellfire. For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the best thing, even Surah Al-Imran said that, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. Those who will be dragged away a little bit from the hellfire, they will not be punished in the hellfire, and they will enter Jannah, فقد فاز. This is the ultimate success. Ultimate success. They are the real winners in this life and in the hereafter too. Brothers, to be honest with you, our scholar, they said, if somebody even will be dragged from the hellfire and he will not enter Jannah, it's good too. It's not bad. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala somehow will protect him from the hellfire. What about if somebody will be dragged away from the hellfire and he will enter Jannah in the same time? He will win twice. He will win twice because he will be dragged away from the hellfire and he will enter Jannah, which is second gift or reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best actually for him to enter Jannah. For that's why, فَمَنْ زُحْزَحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازْ. This is the ultimate success. Ultimate success. The best thing, subhanAllah. Brothers, those who are with me, please try to share this link to your groups, to the people around you, because when I send the message to everybody, some people, they're asking me, some of them, they said, we don't have Facebook. Some of them, they said, Sheikh, send me the link. I am now on my phone. I don't know how to send the link. Just you can share it. You are the listeners. Let me just be busy with what I'm doing, inshallah. Try to share with others, invite everybody, inshallah. special our community to inshallah to بإذن الله عز وجل to get this خير and to share with us this إيمانيات inshallah. The only thing, dear brother and dear sisters, will save you from the hellfire. That's why Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارِ, fear the hellfire. Protect yourself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only thing will protect you from the hellfire, your iman. Your iman, your faith. Wallahi, your faith. Subhanallah. Your money will not benefit you. This is the wasila. This is a way to be survived from the hellfire. Your money will not benefit you. Your position will not benefit you. Your family will not benefit you. Your from this dunya, nobody gonna benefit you. The only thing will benefit you in your grave. The only thing will benefit you in the day of judgment. The only thing will benefit you when you will be above Israat al-Mustaqim. Subhanallah, your good deeds, your iman, your faith. Your faith will be like a light for you in the day of judgment. Israat al-Mustaqim, Israat will be above the hellfire. It's above the, like a bridge. And hellfire under Israat, very thin like a hair and very sharp like a sword. And everybody must pass by that Israat, that bridge above the hellfire, including the Anbiya of Allah, the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the only thing will benefit you, will produce light for you to walk, and the Israat will be full of darkness, dark, completely dark. That's why your iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Protect yourself with doing good deeds as much as you can, which is being prepared to the kafirin. فَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى is warning us now into many ayat of the Holy Quran. Be careful. Don't make anything bad. Try to listen to Allah. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And get that protection. Protection. أي نعم الله سبحانه وتعالى will protect you إن شاء الله. حياكم الله شيخ وائل, يا مرحبا بالدكتور, مرحبا دكتور وائل, welcome دكتور وائل. فالله سبحانه وتعالى is giving us advice now, and the real and the ultimate success, الفوز الكبير, الفوز العظيم, الفوز المبين according to the Quran, when you will be saved from the hellfire and you will enter Jannah, you will win twice. فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز. وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is continuing this ayat. I have like 4 ayah for you today from Surah Al Imran, just to prepare you spiritually and physically to receive the month of Ramadan, because Ramadan is coming after 3-4 days. That's why we need everybody to share this good inshallah with us بإذن الله عز وجل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Verse 132, obey Allah. Obey Allah, وأطيع الله والرسول. والرسول معطوف على الله. أطيع الله, obey Allah and the رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Obey Allah and the messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. You will receive the mercy. لعلك, you might be, إن شاء الله, الله سبحانه وتعالى, he will have mercy on you. لعل مترجي وتمني in Arabic language means إن شاء الله you might be, إن شاء الله, among those who will have the mercy, receive the mercy from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. Obey Allah and obey رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. لعلكم ترحمون. If we talk about رحمة, يعني the month of Ramadan is the month of رحمة. Forgiveness, as I said yesterday, and Allah will free you from the hellfire. You will not be in hell anymore. That's it. فذلك هو الله said, if you obey Allah and the رسول, the messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him, you will obtain the رحمة. You're going to get the mercy. And the mercy, it's very important. What is the meaning of the mercy in the Quran? What is the meaning of the mercy in Islam? The mercy means you will never be tired. See how many people they are tired around the world nowadays? Some of us, some of them, they are dying because of Corona. Some of them because of the poverty. Some of them because of sickness. Some of them because of the hardship they are facing day and night. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to obtain this rahmah, to get the rahmah, the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means you have to obey Allah and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah said in the Holy Quran, for example, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We have sent some ayat from the Holy Quran. These verses, they are shifa. cure already for somebody being sick. If we give medicine to somebody, means he to cure him, right? Means he is suffering because of his sickness, right? That's why he needs some cure. This is called in Arabic shifa. Yeah, some of the ayat of the Quran, it's spiritually shifa to take away from your heart what? Spiritually, doubt of disbelief. And what else? The doubt of disbelief, doubt about Allah, doubt about the deen. And plus also the hypocrisy. There is no hypocrisy in your heart anymore. For the Quran, it's taking all of these illness away, sickness away from your heart spiritually, and also the Quran as a shifa physically. Too many doctors, medical doctors, maybe they will be against me, those who are doesn't know anything about Islam. But the Quran, very important. I believe the Quran more than anybody in the world. The Quran is Kalam Allah, the creator of this dominion, the creator of this universe. So if Allah says something, I believe him more than anybody. If Allah said the Quran, it's a shifa. How the Quran is a shifa? Read Surah Al-Ra'd, read the chapter of the thunder, verse number 31. Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالِ أَوْ قُطَعَتْ بِهِ الْأَرْضِ أَوْ كُلِّمَ بِهِ الْمَوْتَ بَلِ اللَّهِ الْأَمْرُ جَمِيعًا. If it will be a Quran, look at the ayah, look at the verse, look at the meaning. If it will be a Quran, وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالِ. If it will be a Quran to move a mountain from its place to another place, or to cut the earth pieces, or to slander, subhanAllah, to cut the earth with it, or to talk with that Quran to the dead people, it will be our Quran. Allahu Akbar, it will be our Quran. Yes, Quran is a shifa. I told you, physically it's a shifa, and spiritually it's a shifa. More you read the Quran al-Kareem, you don't know the secret of the Quran. The only one he knows the secret of the Quran, Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he said in Surah Al-Kahf and Surah Luqman. Look what Surah Al-Kahf said. وَلَوْ أَنَّمْ قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي لَنَفِدَ الْبَحْرُ قَبْلَ أَنْ تَنْفَدَ كَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي وَلَوْ جِئْنَا بِمِثْلِهِ مَدَدًا. If the ocean became like an ink, you know, and you put it in a pen to explain كلمات الله, the word of Allah, the Quran, البحر will be exhausted, will be dry. خلاص, the ocean will be dry. While you don't know the secret of the Quran. Yes, even we say somebody مفسر, nobody can make tafsir of the Quran. احنا just according to our understanding, we are trying to give the meaning. But nobody knows deeply the meaning of the Quran. Look at Surah, ولو جئنا بمثله مدد. Even if we get ocean plus ocean, as an ink, you cannot explain kalam Allah. Allah, the only one he knows the secret of his kalam, the Quran, the meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look what Allah said in Surah Luqman. وَلَوْ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٍ وَالْبَحْرُ يَمُدُّهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ سَبْعَةُ أَبْحُرٍ مَا نَفِدَتْ كَلِمَاتُ اللَّهِ. If you have the ocean, and you bless that ocean, seven oceans, and that big ocean, give the all of this ocean is like ink also. ولو أن ما في الأرض من شجرة أقلام والبحر يمده من بعده سبعة أبحر ما نافذ كلمة الله. And you make all the trees on the earth like pen, and you fill it with the ocean of these seven oceans to explain the words of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. You cannot. For that's why if somebody, when you tell him Quran is shifa physically and spiritually, and telling you no, just only spiritually, I'll tell him you don't understand. فالشفاء, if you are sick, but الرحمة, we talk about لعلكم ترحمون وأطيعوا الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون, obey Allah and His Messenger, you might obtain or get the رحمة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the رحمة إن شاء الله gonna come to us in the month of Ramadan. Yes, first, يعني this is a weak hadith, but I wanna say it. First 10 days of Ramadan, it's a رحمة. It's a weak hadith. But in general, why I put the رحمة just only in first 10 days? The rahmah in the 30 days, the forgiveness in the 30 days, and the idqi min an-nar every night, inshallah, in the 30 days. Right? Ya jama'a, say salamu alaykum. Sazala, ما فيش سلام ولا هارت ولا جود يا شيخ ولا حاجه، انتوا نايمين ولا ايه؟ Are you sleeping guys؟ I did not finish yet. اوكي اوكي. فالرحمه تتجلى. If you are, you will never get tired. ها؟ سبحان الله. That's why the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. لعلكم ترحمون. If you have mercy, Allah will shower you with His mercy. You will never be tired in your life. Your life will never be miserable. You're going to be the happiest person in this life. And also, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will satisfy you. You're going to have a rida, إن شاء الله رب العالمين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, now Ramadan is coming. If you have any questions, says علاء, maybe you can tell the brothers, إن شاء الله, manage the page. جزاك الله خير with me now. I'm going to leave it to you. If somebody has a question, I can, إن شاء الله, answer your questions in the end of the, end of the, I said, جزاك الله خير. معلش أنا I'm not looking. I'm far away from the phone. That's why you know, I have distance. I cannot see. Okay. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وسارعوا إلى مغفرة. وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. Race with one another to forgiveness from your Lord and Jannah, paradise. Its width, like the width of the heaven and the earth. Allah prepared that Jannah to or for the righteous people, the good doers, the muhsineen, the muttaqeen, the pious people, the pious ones. طيب, let's explain this ayah, subhanAllah. وسارعوا إلى مغفرة. Will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention the word sabiqu or sari'u, race with one another or compete or all of that competition or racing with one another? When he mentioned al-Jannah and al-Akhirah, he mentioned this word. But for dunya, for earnings, your living and your money and your degrees and your education or whatever, he said just walk. You don't have to race. Just walk. Just make some kind of movement, some kind of effort, and Allah will give you, inshallah. That's why he said, هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا. Allah make this earth for you ذلول, like the bed of the baby. ذلول, easy. Mashallah, flat. فامشوا في مناكبها. Just walk. Walk right and left. وكلوا من رزق. And eat from the rizq of Allah, the livelihood of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His provision. وإليه النشور. All of us will go back to Him. He's the one who's going to resurrect us again from our graves. That's why, very important to think about that. But when we come, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to talk about Jannah, about the heaven, about the paradise, about the final destination, about the real future for us, He said, race with one another. And ومغفرة, and مغفرة, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah, inshallah, Allah, as I said yesterday, inshallah, in the beginning of Ramadan, Allah will look at His mu'mineen, Muslimin, with the eye of mercy, inshallah. And if Allah will have mercy on you, inshallah, He will forgive you. That's why Allah said, race with one another to what? Huh? To maghfira, forgiveness. If you seek that forgiveness and you get the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means Allah will never punish you. Forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ومغفرة من ربكم, from your Lord. وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض. Allah mentioned the width of Jannah. It's the small. You know the length, or the length of Jannah is bigger than the width. Like if you have a door, the height or the length of the door, it's higher than or bigger than the width of the door, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the width of Jannah, it's like the width of the heaven and the earth. You have seven earth and seven heavens, right? Seven layers. And Allah did not mention the length of Jannah. Why? Because there is no end for it. There is no end. Nobody knows the value of it. There is no end for it. فالجنه is big. One time, Kisra, the king of Persia, he was, when he read that verse in the Quran, or he heard about it, he sent a message to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, if the width of Jannah gonna be like the width of the heaven and the earth, what is its length or the height of Jannah? You know? And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the answer, and he said, where is the night when the day comes? If you tell me where is the night when the day comes, this is the answer. That's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala capable, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qadir, and qadir ala kulli shay subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you compare, look at the greatness of Allah, the one we worship him, our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's capable. Wallahi, he is capable. If you are poor, he will give you, provide for you. If you are sick, just invoke him. He will give you shifa. If you need anything, just raise your hand to Allah and bow to him. Make sujood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. He will fulfill your wishes. He will give you whatever you want. Especially this month of Ramadan, the days of barakah. Every night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna forgive you, gonna free your neck from the hellfire. Just worship Allah and just do whatever he asked you for. Subhanallah, if you look to the heaven and the earth, and the Jannah, it's like the width of Jannah, like the heaven and the earth. Look at this. Which one is bigger? The chair of Allah or the heaven and the earth? We agreed. We have seven earth and seven heavens. And if you compare the seven heavens and seven earth with the chair of Allah, like a ring, if you have a ring and you throw it in the desert, falah, huge desert, and you have the ring, just you throw it in the desert. This is exactly that small ring in the desert. This is the heaven and the earth comparing to the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is capable or not? Say, brothers and sisters, what do you think? Is Allah capable or not? He is capable, right? Tayyib. If you compare the chair of Allah, where is Allah is putting his foot? The chair, this is mawda' qadamay ar-Rahman. Where is Allah is putting his foot? If you compare the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the arsh, the throne of Allah, with his throne, like if you have the same ring or the ring, huh, and you throw it in a falah, in a desert, big huge desert, means that if you put the chair beside the arsh, the chair, you cannot see it. Allahu Akbar. What about the heaven and the earth? Nothing. What about me and you? Nothing. We are nothing in the dominion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, for Allah capable. Allah capable. And when you worship Allah and you feel that you are the servant and the slave of Allah, say, Alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim. Alhamdulillah, I am a Muslim. Alhamdulillah, Allah is my God. Why? Because you have to be really honored because of that. Some people around you in this world, they're still worshipping cows. During coronavirus, those who used to worship the cows, they get the urine of the cow and they drink. Why? Because it's blessed urine gonna help them to be cured from coronavirus. Corona, go away. Drink urine. What is this? Some people also, their brothers and sisters, they are worshipping rats, snakes, animals. They worship statues, Buddha, Batikha, SubhanAllah, all of this. Is that right? When you see this, you say, Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah, I am a Muslim. Be proud. And say, Alhamdulillah, Allah is my God. Allah is my Lord. He created me. He's taking care of me. He gave me hidayah, guidance. He gave me Islam. I am following his orders. I am fasting Ramadan. Somebody died before Ramadan. Somebody died before Ramadan. Very important, ya jama'a. Very important, inshallah. Okay. Khair, inshallah. Let's follow, inshallah, what I'm saying. If somebody, please, ya jama'a, if somebody has a question, please just say your question politely, and that's it. We don't need to talk about somebody. We don't need to mention anything. You are my guest here, okay? Please, just if somebody has any question, politely, yes, inshallah, you can ask your question. That's all, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. We are here to get the ajr and the hasanat and to get our nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's it, nothing else. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the only one, he knows what is in the heart of the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the only one, he will inshallah count people, and he is the only one, he knows the good and the bad, and he is the only one, he has the day of judgment in his court. All of us are going to stand in the day of judgment. All right? Subhanallah. فالجنة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared the Jannah for المتقين, for the righteous people. Now I'm going to tell you some of the characteristics of the good people, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them with Jannah. He said, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظة والعافين عن الناس والمحسنين. Some of the characteristics of the people of Jannah, which is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to the hadith al-Bukhari, he saw the Jannah already, alayhi salatu wa salam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he already saw the Jannah. And he was about, according to the hadith of al-Bukhari, to get us a bunch of grape from Jannah to the Sahaba. But he said, if I want, I will do it. لفعلت, hadith al-Sahih al-Bukhari. But that Jannah for certain people, not anybody can enter Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in too many ayat in Surah Al-Furqan, in Surah Al-Baqarah, in Surah Al-Imran here, in too many ayat in Surah Al-Ma'arij, He's giving us the sifat, the characteristics, or the characters of the mu'mineen, or those who will enter Jannah, inshallah. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among those who will enter Jannah without any accountability, without any hisab, ya arhamar rahimin, ya rabbil alameen. Some of the characteristics of those who are going to be in Jannah, u'iddat lil muttaqin, the Jannah being prepared for the pious people. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the Jannah? He created the Jannah and he created everything by the word. What did he say? Kun fayakun. Kun fayakun. He said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who are spending their money, جزاكم الله خير, بارك الله فيكم. Those who are spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, جزاكم الله خير, sister نقشبندي حقاني, you will come, جزاكم الله خير, may Allah bless you, amin, amin, inshallah, جزاكم الله خير. Please make dua for me, make dua for everybody, inshallah, make dua for my family, for me, for all the community, and for all of us, inshallah, جزاكم الله خير. فالله سبحانه وتعالى said, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. Those who are spending for the sake of Allah, في السراء. في السراء, during their ease time. During their ease time. إن شاء الله, جزاكم الله خيرا. جزاكم الله خيرا يا شيخ علاء. الذين ينفقون في السراء. Those who are spending for the sake of Allah during their ease time. Okay. طيب, why they are spending? Because they are, mashallah, they are living their life in, mashallah, in plenty of ni'am of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said they are spending while during their ease time and difficult time, hardship time. Taib, when they spend during their ease time, huh, to be grateful to Allah, to say, ya Rab, tashakkur, alhamdulillah, you give me this and this and this and this, you give me too many things, that's why I'm spending for your sake. For shukr, for tashakkur. During their ease time, huh, they, subhanallah, they are spending. What darra? What is the darra? Darra, during the poverty, sickness, dur, subhanallah, huh? But darra, during their hardship time, they are spending. Why? To tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rab, because of my sadaqah, please help me. See? All the affairs of the mu'min are good for him. He will be grateful during his ni'mah, when Allah favor him with something, and he will be patient. He will be patient if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him any calamity, or he been struck by any calamity or anything like that. Now people, they are suffering from coronavirus. Too many people, they are dying. More than 2 million around the world now, they have coronavirus. In America, almost 700,000, they have corona, almost 700. I did not see today how much now. And too many, more than like 40,000 died. This is in America, just only in America. And around the world, this plague, global plague, subhanAllah. It's wabaa. That's why during this time, what we have to do? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like a flood, flood is coming, subhanAllah destroying some people with their homes, and some people being saved. And somehow that flood gonna stop. Somehow that plague gonna stop. The scholars of Islam, Sheikh Nabilsi, I heard something today. He said the maximum time of this corona gonna take 5 months. Because the scholars of Islam, they said that. They're going to go with a certain circle. After 5 months, this is the maximum. The saqf, the roof of it, going to stop. Nothing else. Everything will come back, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. But ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save you, to save your family, to save all of your community, to save all Muslim ummah from the sickness or from corona or from any plague or from any harm. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Yibba, one of the characteristics of those who are spending fi sarra during their ease time to be grateful to Allah, wa darra to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help them to take this away inshaAllah. Fil usri wal yusri. Wal kaazimeen al ghaidh. Those who are during their anger, they are swallowing their anger. Kaazimeen al ghaidh. Yes, I can hurt somebody, I can do something to somebody, but because of my Islam, because of my Iman, I will control my anger. And the word kadhimin in Arabic means like if you have something and just you swallow it while you don't like it, but you swallow it. Alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. See, فَدَسُ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ, those who are controlling their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and those who are pardoning people. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, Allah Almighty loves those who are righteous, those who are making good deeds, subhanAllah. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. وَالَّذِينَ, some of their characteristics too. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً, and those who are they make fahisha. Fahisha means illegal sexual intercourse. If we see the word fahisha or fawahish in the Holy Quran, it's talking about zina, wal'azu billah. It's talking about illegal sexual intercourse. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَحِشَ أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Because if you make illegal sexual intercourse, it means you oppress yourself. You are unjust to yourself. ذَكَرُوا اللَّهُ أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهُ. طيب. The one who is making haram or guna or making sin, major sin. This ayah talks about those who are making major sin. Al-fahisha. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk highly about Prophet Joseph, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty said, كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاء. Likewise, we, subhanAllah, take the harm of السوء, the bad deeds, and the الفحشاء away from Prophet Joseph. He did not make the minor sins and the big one, which is الفحشاء, the illegal sexual intercourse. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him from all of that. For those who commit that, they make it because of their ignorance. Those who commit it because of their oppression to themselves, yes, they oppress themselves. And dhakarullah, and during that time when they disobeyed Allah, they did not remember His name. That's why Allah said dhakarullah, they mentioned the name of Allah. Ha, when you make that and you say astaghfirullah and you mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fastaghfaru li dhunubihim, and they said astaghfirullah al-azim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayh. They ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness. And they still mu'mineen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, even if they make fahisha, even if they ask Allah for forgiveness, they are still under the umbrella of al-Iman. Yes, al-Iman is not going away from them. Because they ask Allah for forgiveness, and they ask Allah for forgiveness because of their sins. وَمَنْ يَغْفُرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Who will forgive sins except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes, Allah, the only one He can forgive your sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. This is a very important point. They are not stubborn. Some people, when they are stubborn, and stubbornness will the end of it, or the bad results of the stubbornness, al-kufr wal-azu billah. Yes, because the shaitan, he was very stubborn. Shaitan, he was very stubborn. How shaitan was very stubborn? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gave order to the angels, bow to Adam, make sujood. He said, no. What? No, I will not. Why? He said, I'm better than him. You created him from clay, but you created me from the flame of the fire. And he was thinking, shaitan, Mr. Shushu, Satan, he was thinking that that fire better than clay, which is not right. If you want to put any seed or anything to grow up, put it in the clay, in the dirt. But if you want to fire anything destroyed, put it in the, put fire in it, right? But just put fire in it, you'll destroy it. فاحنا, Shaitan was thinking, and the first person who was evaluating things, Shaitan, and he was wrong, was mistaken. Ibn Kathir said that. فالشيطان, he refused. Why? Because he was very stubborn, and he said, I am better than him. خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين. You created him from the flame of, created me from the flame of the fire, and created him from the clay. I'm better than him. This is what the shaitan said. That's why stubbornness is not good. And Allah's talking in this verse about one of the characteristics of the mu'mineen. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. Aywa. They are not stubborn. They are not stubborn. All the time when they make sin, whenever, they ask Allah for His forgiveness. Until when? Until the shaitan, his nose will be on dirt. Because the shaitan, sometimes he can come to you and he's gonna say, listen, listen, do you think Allah will forgive you? You make a lot of sin in your life. He will never forgive you. Allah said, no, I will forgive you. Did you kill 100 people? Did you read that hadith? The man, he killed 100 people. He didn't kill even chicken. Alhamdulillah. Why you give up? Don't despair Allah's mercy. Allah Kareem, Allah Rahim, Allah Wadud, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. He is the one, he can forgive all the sins. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. But another verse in Surah Nisa, Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih. If you commit shirk, no. There is no forgiveness with shirk. Fa ya jama'a, wallahi, yani, really, don't forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Huh? أُولَئِكْ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. Bismillah. Don't be among those who forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let them forget about themselves. If somebody forget about himself, he doesn't know nothing. He's in the middle of nowhere, you know. Subhanallah, Allah create us for a mission, and whatever, don't forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ إِذَا نَسِيتَ. Allah said that in Surah Al-Kahf. Whenever you feel you forget about Allah a little bit like this, mention His name. Say, لا إله إلا الله. Say, استغفر الله. Say, الحمد لله. Make تسبيح, make ذكر, inshallah, رب العالمين. فالاستغفار, the meaning of الاستغفار, saying, استغفر الله وأتوب إليه, asking Allah for His forgiveness and making tawbah, means you are not stubborn. And this is one of the good characteristics of the mu'mineen, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Allah said the reward of these people, ulaika, those, jaza'uhum, the great reward of them, maghfirah, again maghfirah, forgiveness from their Lord, wa jannat, and gardens underneath rivers flow, wa jannatin tajri min tahtaha al-anhar khalidina fiha, they're gonna live in these gardens for eternity, forever. خالدين فيها. Another ayat said خالدين فيها أبدا. سبحان الله. يا جماعة, if you go to Jannah, nobody gonna kick you out from Jannah. خلاص. خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين. We have to understand that when Allah said ونعم أجر العاملين, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, your عبادة will not benefit him. Even if you disobey Allah, you will never harm Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it's the great reward for those who are practicing their Islam, those who are working. It's a great ajr from Allah. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the characteristics of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are making little deeds like this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply to us. We make hasana, Allah multiplied to 10. We make hasana, Allah multiplied to 700 times. And we make some hasanat, there is no reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not show the reward of these hasanat to any of his angels or to anybody. Like fasting. قال كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم. All the good deeds of the son of Adam, I showed to him his reward. If you make, if you read one letter of the Quran, you're gonna get this hasanat. If you make this salah, you're gonna get 27 daraga. If you make sadaqah, you're gonna get this. All we know all everything except fasting. Do you know why? Because fasting, there is some kind of secret between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can tell everybody in the California. Shout loud, ya jama'a, I fast, I'm fasting today, even all California, I'm fasting today, but I go to my closet, I have some chocolate there, you know, I can eat it, and nobody knows what I'm doing, but Allah knows, that's why it's a secret between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ Ya jama'a, today I talk about, I'm going to finalize, if you have any question, now inshallah I can answer your questions, please, prepare it. How to protect yourself from the hellfire? Allah prepared it for the kafirin. And if Allah save you from the hellfire and go to Jannah, you win twice. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, how to do that? To protect yourself, obey Allah and His Messenger. You're going to obtain the rahmah. You're going to get the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And race with one another to Allah, to His forgiveness, to the Jannah, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. And in the end of this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the characteristics of the believer. Of the believers, the mu'mineen, those who will go to Jannah, عدت للمتقين الذين. The Jannah, Allah prepared for the righteous people, the pious ones, الذين, those who are. We're going to talk about the characteristics of the mu'mineen, those who are الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء, those who are spending in السراء والضراء, والكاظمين الغيظ, those who are controlling their anger, والعافين عن الناس, those who are pardoning people. And Allah loves the good doers, the righteous ones. I said, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَحَشَةً And those who commit فواحش, illegal sexual intercourse, or haram, or any guna, or anything like this. SubhanAllah, and they did zulm. They were unjust to themselves. They remember Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they ask Allah for His forgiveness. And there is no one can forgive except Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, وَمَنْ يَغْفَرُ ذُنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And they are not stubborn. Stubbornness is not good in Islam. If somebody is stubborn, he's like Namrud, he's like Fir'aun, he's like Qarun, he is like, الشيطان, Mr. Shushu. الشيطان, عارفين الشيطان? Mr. Shushu. أيوة. If somebody is stubborn, he is Shaitan Sagir. Shaitan Kabir, Mr. Shushu. Iblis, what is the stubbornness will lead to the hellfire, the kufr, and will lead to the hellfire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am Kareem, I am Rahim, I am Wadud. Little you are doing, give you great reward. Hasana will be multiplied to 700 times. Hasana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, inshallah, surprise with its reward in the day of judgment. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tonight, to make all of us among those who will go to Jannah al-Firdaus al-A'la with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba and with our parents and grandparents. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to give shifa to everybody sick, Ya Rabbil Alameen, and to give mercy, to shower anybody die from the Muslims, to shower him with mercy and rahmah and forgiveness and tranquility. May Allah give us peace in our hearts. May Allah give us peace in our mind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us more life, inshallah, and empower us to worship Him in Ramadan, to pray Salat al-Taraweeh and to read the Quran, to make khatm al-Quran, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. The good news is, inshallah, please let everybody know about that. I will be with you, inshallah, every night from tonight and from yesterday, from 9 p.m., inshallah, to 11, inshallah, p.m. Yani tomorrow, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, just like this time for 30 minutes, from 9 to 9:30. Please try to invite everybody to my page in Facebook. And also, inshallah, from Thursday night, you will see me leading Salat al-Taraweeh from Islamic Center of Reseda. Masjid will be closed. Masjid will be closed. There is nobody in the masjid, just me and Brother Qasim. Okay, I'm gonna lead Salat al-Tarawih from there, and you're gonna see me at Payam Afghan TV. It's international TV. And in the same time, if you don't have that TV, just go to www.payameafghantv.com. You're gonna see the link there in the internet, live. Or if you don't know any one of these, just go to Sayyid Jumaa in my YouTube channel. Just click Sayyid Jumaa. Go to Sayyid Jumaa, S-A-Y-E-D, space J-U-M-A-A. I'm leading Salat al-Tarawih every night, 20 rak'ahs. Again, I have lecture. The program starts from 9 to 11 p.m. 9 to 11 p.m. every night. Inshallah, fix your time with me. I'm going to start the lecture, inshallah. We'll talk about the treasures of Ramadan. Every night, different culture. Different lecture every night for 30 minutes. Then, I'm going to start Salat al-Tarawih because I'm going to pray Isha before the lecture, inshallah. We're going to pray Isha in each time. Then from 9 exactly, for 20 minutes, 30 minutes lecture, then we're going to stand for Salat al-Tarawih to Raka'ah. I am, again, giving fatwa, according to the scholars, the ulama. Those who are in my area, in Reseda, those who live in the valley area where I live, you can pray behind me Salat al-Tarawih, inshallah. If you are in Anaheim or different place, I'm not advising you to do that because I'm not your imam. This is different zoning, different qibla there. I don't know what's going on there. But in my area, why? Those who are around the masjid, consider the masjid like a microphone above the... Maybe somebody gonna tell me, yeah, Sheikh, because the Salat al-Jama'ah must be lines and rows must be continued behind the Imam in the same place. And the brothers, we are in the time of Nawazil, Darura, necessity. Masajid never being closed. All the masajid around the world one time in Ramadan. Even Mecca and Medina never happened. We are in time of Nawazil. Believe me, if people doesn't have Imam, no Imam for them, nobody gonna pray Salat al-Tarawih. For you. And the rest, they're going to eat halwa, sweet, watching TVs, talking with the family, playing. Nobody going to pray. You have to follow the imam and you have to. If you don't want to pray behind me, at least open your Quran, make khatm al-Quran. And again, make khatm, inshallah. And the night of 27th, 19th of May, we're going to make khatm al-Quran for all the community, inshallah. And the dua, bi-izn Allah Azza wa Jal, as if you are in the masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Share this video. Share it to everybody, inshallah. Let everybody listen to this khair. And may Allah accept from all of us. Any question, ya Mawlana? There is no questions, eh? Taib, if there is no questions, inshallah, then you can ask, inshallah, put in your comment, you can ask me. Or if you have any questions, just, inshallah, type it to me and I will get it later and I will, inshallah, answer it. Or if you have any question now, will be great if I can answer. If not, and I will see you tomorrow, inshallah, bi-iznillah. Jazakum khairan. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Fi amanillah.